Good morning, Internet. So, just going to type a couple of things. And we are going to be doing a Swiss. Fate Reforged. While I actually listen to Sintaku's stream as well, because there's no sound whatsoever coming from Mako. Dragons. And it fired. So, green white dragon. Butcher's Glee is nice, of course. Final Dragonfire. I think I'm gonna go with a Scale Lord here, because, you know, it's good. And I like green white. Green white isn't too bad. I mean, I prefer green red, but. Yeah. Scale Lord, Green Ratty. I do not feel that rare was worth the card. Okay. Profound Journey. Bowmasters. Artful Maneuvers, pretty good. That's not too bad. That might wheel. That's only till end of turn. Palace Familiar draws a card. Territorial Rock. I think we're gonna take the rock here. Yeah. Take the Sunstriker, I guess. That's not too bad. But I want the double striking bird first. Even Tactician. Ah, red green. Too bad I'm not in red green. What do we got? Revealing Wind. Worst fog ever. Take the one drop. Do we take the Scale Guard Sentinels, or do we take the bear? Yeah, Sentinels. We need two drops. Servant of the Scale. It's a 1-1 for one that gives away a 1-1 counter later. Tread upon. It's a good combat track. Purge came round. Take the defender, I guess. Go two drop heavy. Two drops are good. Two drops are important. I need more green cards, though. I mean, the Scale Lord's pretty good. Especially when I'm flipping up cards, getting... I need to take more Megamorphs, to be honest. Ooh, I did not see that Dunecaster earlier. But the Shield Bearer is who we need to take. Because Megamorph and Enduring Scale Lord. So one drop, two drops, three drops. Five drop, six drop. Take the Nemesis out. Take the Glint out. Somebody else can have the really bad fog. And I mean really bad fog. Impact Tremors. And a Swamp. Not bad. I mean, 11 playables. That's decent. Because if I can get the Scale Guard Sentinels after I've got the Scale Guard on the field, plus one counters for everything. Ooh, Dromoka's Command. Yep. Yeah, Dromoka's Command. It's a green, white, rare. Go for it. It's an on-color rare. Yay! Excuse me while I get a water. There we go. Certainly taking their time picking. Let's see. Shape the Sands. Arnax. Breaker, Naturalize, another Dunecaster, and a Dromoka Warrior. Beastbreaker, I think. Ooh, Circle of Elders. Silk Wrap. Another Guardian, but that'll probably come around. Yep. Take the Circle of Elders. They seem good. Dromoka's Monument, Lightwalker, Sandstorm Charger. The Sandstorm Charger will probably wheel. So we're going to take the Monument because it's fixing, which is good. And it can be a creature later on. Naturalize, Pinion Feast, another Territorial Rock. Pinion Feast. Yeah, it's a 5-drop, but it'll kill a dragon and bolster too, so some late game crush there. We need more 1-drops. I'd like another Servant of the Scale or two. Ooh, Collected Company. Unlock a top 6-year card, put up to 2 creatures, but convert them again, and it costs 3 or less from among them onto the battlefield, put the rest onto the bottom of your library, or another Servant to the Scale, or a pacifism. Collected Company. Enduring Victory. Lightwalker. Another 2-drop. Goes with my Collected Company. I have a lot of targets for Collected Company. That's what happens when you go heavy on the 2-drops. At least it's not, you know, look at the top 6 of your cards in your library, put 2 of them in onto the field, and ditch the rest. Segmented Crotic for the top end. Of course, it's a decent way to get rid of your bombs. Maybe I can get an Enduring Wilds, crack that off after you do it. Take the Vegetation. Turn 5, end up with a lot of mana. Dunecaster. Take this foil encase in ice. Because, you know, foil. Lightwalker. More stuff for Collected Company. Naturalize for the board. Foul Tongue Shriek. And an island. Pack 3, and we already have 21 to it. Oh, nice. Swiftwater Cliffs isn't in our colors. Most of these aren't, so Wild Call it is. That's 2-drop. Thank you. Yeah. If I know what the top card of my library is, so I need Scry somehow. If I can scry the top of my library somehow, wind call it. But hey, I mean, worst comes to worst, it's a 2-2 for two. Fruit of the first tree. Nice. Daughter of Adamant, though. Dagatar the Adamant. Oh, yeah, we're taking Dagatar. Dagatar and Enduring Scale Lord. Elite Scale Guard. Blossoming Sands. Green White. Two drops. All right, we're gonna cut one of these guys. No, I like those. You can get out for now. No, because that's counters. Maybe the vegetation. Light form. Flying and lifelink. So take the light form. Dragon. Enoch guide. Board that, I guess. Cut the dragon. I still need to get rid of two more cards. Yeah, we're gonna take another sands. Can never have too many sands. Could take fixing in a two color deck. Woo! Still need to cut cards. Yeah, we're gonna cut Segmented Crotic. Cut the invocation, I guess. Ancestral Vengeance. And map the wastes. So put these two back in, add basic lands, and done, I guess. Yep, done. It's probably not a great deck, but I think it's pretty good. We got a pair of 4-drop, or 6-drop 4/4s that do fun things. We've got Dagutar. That moves counters around. I wonder how that. When one or more +1/+1 counters are placed on another creature you control, he gets one. So if I Dagutar one of their token, or one of theirs onto one of mine, and then he gets one. Or, if I have him on the field, he gets a +1/+1 counter for the 4 going on to Dagutar, I think. Right? Because Dagutar enters the field, and then you put 4 +1/+1 counters on him. So yeah, okay. I've got a couple creatures that get +1/+1 counters. Servant of the Scale, really. It's the only one I think I've got that comes in. The other one. But that's 2. And then I've got a Megamorph here. I can tap their guys. I got a couple of bolsters. Yeah, now we're just waiting around. Because our deck was good, I guess. We got 9 white sources, 10 green sources. Sort by color. Right, we also have him. No idea how this is going to perform. Should be fun, though. So yeah, just waiting on everybody else to submit decks. It can't be that hard. I was done in about 3 seconds. Green, white, 2 drops. Lightform also do counters. No, it just says flying and lifelink. That's fine. I mean, that's not too bad. You get a 2/2 flyer with lifelink for 3 that can possibly be flipped up to be itself with flying and lifelink. Which would be hilarious as if it was like a scale guard or the enduring scale lord. It's like, yeah, it's got flying and lifelink and flying. So I've got 3 dragons to turn on the, well, 2.5 dragons, really. I can have 3 dragons if I have 8 mana out, right? 6 mana to activate the monument, 2 mana to cast the orator, and then, yeah. Excuse me. Two that I can reveal and 3 that I can have on the board. Really wish I had gotten some more dragons. But I've got a couple of guys that are decent low end. And then bolster stuff to bolster up. Guys to move counters around. Guys to get extra counters when I counter on another thing. Will you people please submit your decks? There we go. I have a feeling I'm fighting Hawkser. Just a feeling I've got. Yep. Hello, and good luck. I've got to turn 1 play. I've got to turn 2 play. I'm on the... Yeah, I'm on the draw. I'll keep. Come on, green. Okay, my opponent is blue-black. Counter? Anticipate. Hey, Forest. So he's blue, black, white, right into being. It's fine, I can block your stuff all day long. Green collected company. Wow. All whiff. Total whiff. That's okay. I can get shield guard out. I can get Anat Guide out. I have 6 mana. Circle of Elders, please. Plus one counters. Yeah, you want to get that manifest in there? Come on, come on. Because you know I can kill it. Yep, figured. I am fine with that. That. One, two, three. It's 4 to bring it up. Two, four, six. It's okay. photo yields. He exploited it itself. I'll take five. Sadly, I don't have the ferocious yet. What you got? Coton Butcher's Glee. That's got flying. Yeah, that was gonna go badly. Yeah. Nice. Of course, he's got Deathwind. Hey, Renanko. Three dragons. Yeah, it was bad. Your monk is not attacking, I don't care what you cast. Have Dromoka's command. And he doesn't have an enchantment yet, so. Hopefully he plays an enchantment. Crap. Let it resolve, you jerk. Nope. That works, I guess. That's 2, 4. Five, six on his turn. I can do it. You get tapped. Okay. He gets trample and a +2/+2. Target creature. Counter? Butcher's Glee. It was close. I almost got away with it. Seven. Dagatar, you're useless. Jeez. That was bad. Yeah, I knew I was dead. This is my deck at the moment. It's a bit 2-drop heavy, but yeah. This is, of course, my sideboard. I actually had this completely whiff, despite the fact that a third of my deck is less than 2-drop, or less than 3 mana cost. Completely whiff. It's like I got... This was, you know, this was cast, so I had 6 cards that I couldn't hit. I hit 6 lands. It's like, come on. Hey, next round starting. We're going to play King Cole. And everybody either won out both their games or lost both their games. Oh no, we get the flower guy. Oh, okay. Yes, I would like to play first. I will keep this. Turn 2, I can play 2 Dragonite Sentries. Defenders with first strike. Blossoming Sands goes first. I think next turn I get down a light form. Hey, there's the Ward Scale Dragon. And we manifest a plains. So who are you going to do to... Oh, yeah, the manifest. You get a planes. Congratulations. All right, get Dunecaster down there. If you ain't got a flyer, man. I can actually get that planes back as a planes. I have Enchantment Destruction. Yeah, this guy's never getting through. He may have a 2-1 with Death Touch, but I have 1/3s with First Strike. Blossoming Sands. You get tapped. I only have 5. Him. I know, I have a 4/4 Anok guide. Yeah, tapping down enemies is fun. I mean, I can't attack with it at the moment, but you know. Soon, very soon. And those counters are going to come in handy, because yeah, like, if I had mana up here, I'd tap his Death Toucher and attack with the crew. Or, well, attack with the Anok guide, really. He'd chump with the Goblin token, clearly. I have Dagatar, who lets me move the counters around. You saw that last turn. So I can take those +1/+1 counters and like put one on a light walker, and I can do all sorts of things with the +1/+1 counters. So can't wait to get him down. He can't, once I'm in the attack step, he can't cast spells at all. So no tricks on his end, which would be nice. No attacks. Nice. Hey, there's the forest. There's the war scale. Yeah, well, no combat tricks from his side. I should have. Yeah, he pacified my ward scale dragon. That's okay. I completely forgot. When I attack with a guy with a +1/+1 counter, I get to tap one of his creatures. So I'm going to be attacking with the Anok guide this turn. Tap down the Death Toucher. Well, no, because then he blocks with the Bloodfire Enforcers. Are you going to let my Servant of the Scale resolve, please? But I can always block his Bloodfire Enforcer, so. Also, I said hello and good luck, and he didn't respond. So, I concur with your what a jerk. Did you forget how First Strike works, sir? Because I didn't. That's okay. Yep. Throw the light walker under the bus. And it's five to flip up, so I can do that next turn. Yeah, I still took four trample, but that's better than five trample. Come on, give me something good. Can I do that? Five. Yes, I can. Tap all your stuff. Quick, now block the 1/1. Block the 1/1. Or do that. take a lot. Five, six, seven. He can kind of kill me. Trumpet blast. No? Any burn spell. Any burn spell. Yeah, they die. He's dead next turn. Any burn spell at all. Okay, sack a creature. My dragon, which is pacified. Wait, you think I'm a sack a creature that actually matters? Keep this. Turn one play, turn two play. Both colors, a trick. Totally effed that up. I played that wrong. It's fine. Use the wild slash on that, please. One more land, and I can play the Aven Tactician, which will kill your imp. No blocks? Okay. Don't think this guy knows how to play a dash deck. So that's 7. Yeah. Pacifying my Aven Tactician, that's fine. Still only 7. Trade for you guys. Idiot. Twin Bolt, yeah, see, Light Form would have done it. Okay, no, don't need none of those. I'm gonna bring in the wild call, take out the one sentry. Blossoming Sands. Yeah, I know I probably should have gone Forest, Servant of the Scale, but I'm fine right now. because now I have an 0-4 with Defender. That can now become a 1-5. Because I will block that 2-1 death touch all day. Duress. Non-creature, non-land. Sorry, sir. I don't have any non-creature, non-land cards in my hand. So I can get the Scale Guard down next turn. Oh, and it's bolstering the Serpent of the Scale. Sarkon's Rage, that guy. That's fine. Say hello to all my dragons. What you got? Throw 3 minutes for what? X is the number of creatures you control. 1, 2, 3, 4. I don't think that's going to work the way you want it to work, dude. That was gonna be next. He was dead next turn. Flunge wins. I've got Ferocious, so it's a one-sided fog. All his stuff dies, and I win the game. Yeah, this was just gonna get mean. Scale guards. So, hey, I won in round two. I run in round one in round two. So, who are we going to play next? Reaper's Rage, maybe? Yeah, it looks like Reaper's Rage. Because he's gone 1-1. I'm 1-1. We both won 2-1. So yeah, I think that went pretty well. I'm rather happy about that. That was just a good set of draws. And my opponent not reading what the cards do, because, you know, I had open mana, I have a card that can move a +1/+1 counter, and you can only do 4 damage off of that spell. So I move a +1/+1 counter, your spell fizzles, basically, and I get to blow you up next turn. All right, we are going to take a quick break because I'm going to go to the bathroom real quick. So we shall return momentarily. And we're back. Still waiting for round three, but you know, shouldn't take too long. How much is Dagatar worth? He can't be worth that much, can he? Ticket? Maybe? No? Not much. He's listed, so he's worth something. You still haven't shown up, Scale Lord. You need to do that. I want to have Dagatar out, move a counter, and have that trigger Scale Lord's ability. Because that would be funny. I've made two mistakes, so no, that's wrong. There we go. That does not count as a third punt, just because I can't remember the commands properly. I was ranked 8th in that. That sucks. Actually, that means I'll probably play whoever's wins of King Cole and Kindleus. And I've dropped 221 frames, which is 0.13%. Almost a tenth of a percent. A little over. Eh, whatever. It's fine. Everything's fine. No need to worry. Everything is fine. So what do we do when we do this? GeoGuessr, right? Now, I play on hard mode, which means I have to make my guess based on this view. I am very quiet. I apologize. Let's try that. Tell me if that's better. But yeah, so I play on hard mode. I'm going to say this is someplace in the United States. Here-ish. Nope. Argentina. That's somewhere in the U.S. Ooh, close. This is clearly someplace in Europe. Germany-ish? Yeah, I'm thinking someplace Germany-ish. Nope. They blurred out somebody's side window. Some place in Brazil. No. Up by the Ukraine. Okay, we're in back in Europe someplace again. They got solar on the roof. They use English characters, not Cyrillic. France, maybe? Spain. It's very, very hard to score very well playing GeoGuessr this way. Oh, yeah, thanks. Dirt road. This could either be somewhere in South, the Badlands of South Dakota, or in like Peru. Chile. Okay. While these pictures are crap, this is the US. I'm gonna say someplace in West Virginia. Oh! I was right. You gotta like it when, you know, you're playing hard mode and your picture is a tree. Now there's evergreens off to the left, but deciduous in the front. And then we have a red barn up in the upper section. This tells me nothing. So I'm gonna go someplace in Europe. Romania-ish. Norway. So I was still right. It was someplace in Europe. Another dirt road. Australia. I think Australia. No, well, Thailand. It's kind of close. Northern US, I think. Hey, look at that. Northern US. 8,000 points. Actually, 9,000. That is not bad for looking at a picture and going, oh, I think maybe over here. You guys are gonna go to time? Yeah, see, that's how Lur needs to start playing it. You get the picture, you can't Google anything, you can't move the picture, you have to make a guess on just what you see. Now, to be fair, some of the ones Cam has had of you get a picture of a white wall are rather difficult to guess. If these guys are going to time, that means it's going to be a grindy game next round for me. Sixteen minutes. How'd we do? 15 minutes, 8 minutes, 7 minutes. But hey, I'm 1-1 today, so that's I'm doing fairly well so far. I've got a pack, which is nice. I like that the 6-2-2-2-2-2-2s have stuck around. I'm not, you know, willing to play in any of them yet because I suck. But it's nice that they're getting better prizes out for those kind of things. It's like an 8-4, only more people get prizes. There we go. Yep, so I'm playing Kindless. And we're playing for fifth. Unless I can go 2-0 and somebody else in one of the upper matches goes 0-2. At least our first round opponent's gone 2-0. And he actually responded when we said hello and good luck to him, which is nice. Go. I lost the die roll. Hello and good luck, sir. Okay. Got three lands, but they're all the wrong color. Mulligan. Keep. I he mulligan two, so that's fine. He mulligan to six. He's gonna go to 5-5-5-5-5-5-5. He kept, so we're going to keep as well. Play out the sands. We're winning! 21-20. We can guide next turn. Because I'd rather hold back the orator till I have a dragon. Unless I get a dragon, then I'll play the orator out. Nope, got Tremokish Command, though. So we will play... Thanagot Guide. Plus one counter, please. Red, blue. We're going to attack. Do you have a block, sir? No blocks? Okay. Triggering raid? No? Just more morphs? We're playing the morph deck! Block? Tread upon your guy. Nice. Okay. I can actually block that. He's got lots of blue. He's kind of stuck on red, though. And I still have Dromoka's Command up, which is nice. rebounding that. Okay, that's fine.